Good morning, dear students. A warm welcome to our English class. Hope you're happy with your lovable parents, right? So be safe. Today, you're going to learn the new lesson from Unit 2, Prose. The topic is The Queen of Boxing. Type, autobiography. Theme, self-confidence. Author, M.C. Mary Kom. The Queen of Boxing is an autobiography of M.C. Mary Kom, a highly talented and courageous boxing champion. Her life story is a source of inspiration and encouragement to all of us. Her grit and self-confidence, which took her to the summit, are remarkable. Self-confidence is important to both your physical health and your psychological well-being. When you believe in yourself, you are more like to try more new things. So, trust the process, trust your intuitions, trust yourself. Okay, let's learn the lesson, The Queen of Boxing, elaborately in the next video. Keep learning. Okay, students. Let us start the lesson. The Unit 2, Prose, The Queen of Boxing, M.C. Mary Kom. First, you see warm-up questions. We use various sports equipments to play different indoor and outdoor games. Now, associate the following sports equipment with their corresponding sports or games. Here are some sports equipments name given. So you have to associate the following sports equipment with their corresponding sports and games. Right. First one is spear, racket, pawns, puck, stump, bow and arrow, club, oar, striker, saber, dice, baron. Okay, now I'll give you first two answer and you have to find out the rest and write in a notebook and send it to me. Okay, first one is spear, corresponding sport game is javelin, right? Next one is racket, corresponding game is badminton. Okay, like this, all the remaining equipments with the corresponding sports and games, you have to write in your notebook and send it to me. Okay, next question, have you won any medals? What are the levels to be accomplished to become an international sports person? Once again, I repeat the question, have you won any medals? What are the levels to be accomplished to become an international sports person? This you write in your notebook and send it to me. What is your favorite sport? Do you play any sport? So write all this. In India, the number of women careers in sports is considerably less when compared to men. What do you think are the reasons? Discuss with your partner and share the ideas with the class. Class means you cannot discuss with your friends like that, but you have to chat with your friends and get an idea and write in your notebook, write the points and send it to me. Regardless of the challenges faced, some women have achieved great success in the field of sports. Here is a list of Indian women celebrities. You can see in this tabular column. Women celebrities who are accomplished in the field of sports and games. Match their names with the sports or games they are associated with by drawing lines. One has been done for you. As an example, see, Sania Mirza, tennis. So like that, what you have to do? You identify on the slides a few personalities who are part of sports, both men and women. You can choose the correct answer for this and write in your notebook and send it to me. So these are the questions given in the warm-up page. Okay, let us start the lesson. Okay, students, before we start the lesson, we must learn the difficult words and its meaning in this lesson. Okay, as a glossary, page number 38. Page number 38. Okay. First, I read out the difficult words, and then I read the meanings of the words. Okay. First one, you see, princely. Princely means very large. Next one is jet lag. Jet lag means a tired and unpleasant feeling a person experiences following a long flight through different time zones. Okay, next one is appetite. Appetite means hunger. Next one is lauded. Lauded means appreciated. Next one is conviction. Conviction means firm faith or belief. Next one is sat. Sat means satisfy. Next one is palate. Palate means sense of taste. The next one is felicitation. Felicitation means congratulatory address. Next one is adulation. Adulation means appreciation. Next one is etched, means imprinted. Next one is speculation. Speculation means guess. Last one is haul. Haul means taking a collection. Okay. You read out each and every word at home. Okay. Pronounce the word well and understand the meaning of the difficult words. Okay. Okay. Right. Next we'll go to the learn about the author. Okay. The author of this lesson, Mangte Chunnichang Mary Kom, was born on 1st March 1983 in Manipur. She is an Indian boxer. She is known as MC Mary Kom, Magnificent Mary, or simply Mary Kom. She is a winner of 5 World Boxing Championship and an Olympic bronze medal in 2012. As a schoolgirl, she used to play a variety of sports, hockey, football, and athletics. Inspired by a Manipuri boxer, Dingo Singh, who won a gold at the Asian Games in 1998, Mary Kom took up boxing. She won the first medal of silver in Pennsylvania, USA, in 2001. She is the only woman boxer to have won a medal in each of the 6 world championships. She was honored with the Padma Shri in 2010 and the Padma Bhushan in 2013 for her wonderful achievements in the field of sports. She wrote her autobiography Unbreakable in 2013. She has been ranked as number 4 AIBA World Women's Ranking Flight Weight Category. That's all about the author Mangte Chunnichang Mary Kom. Okay, students, let us start the lesson. First, I read out the passage. Listen carefully, then I'll give you detailed explanation of the passage. Take page number 34. The autobiographies of accomplished sports persons are replete with the challenges they faced and their single-minded pursuit towards their goal. Such a book is sure to make an interesting as well as an inspirational read. Now, read an excerpt from MC Mary Kom's autobiography, Unbreakable. Soon after the Bangkok Championship, I was selected in the 48 kg 48 kg category for the International Boxing Association. Originally, the association internationally D-Boxy Amateur or the AIBA, AIBA, World Women's Boxing Championships in Pennsylvania, USA in November to December 2001. My father managed to collect only rupees 2000 for my trip. I was both upset and very worried because I had heard of how expensive things were in America. But there was nothing my parents or I could do. I spoke to Onler. Onler is the husband of Mary Kay. One of my friends about my problem, he invited a few students and elders who went to meet the two members of parliament and seek their help. Two MPs donated rupees 5,000 and rupees 3,000 respectively. I suddenly had rupees 10,000 in my hands. With this princely sum means amount, and a little more that had been collected from people, I left for the US. I was relieved to have money in my pocket. I knew that I could not come back. I could not come back empty-handed after all the efforts that people had made on my behalf. Okay, children, this is a passage reading. Now I'm going to give a detailed explanation of the passage. So, in this passage, what we are going to learn about Mary Kay, autobiography of Mary Kay, Unbreakable, lack of finance, trust and support of friends and people, favorable conditions, success after success, the first silver medal and golden experience. So these are the things we are going to learn from this passage. Okay. See, the autobiography of accomplished Mary Kay titled Unbreakable is replete with the challenges and she faced, and it is an account of her single-minded pursuit towards achieving her goal. Coming from a poor family of Manipur, Mary Kay did not have financial resources to support her career. The support of Onler means her husband, her friend, her father, donations from good people and friends made her participate in the World Boxing Championship in USA. Right? Soon after Bangkok Championship, she was selected in the 48 kg category for International Boxing Association, AIBA, AIBA. While teammates lost continuously, Mary went on to reach the finals. The boxers were not unbeatable, as she had thought. She felt that it was a place that would change her life. She kept on telling herself that she could face anyone in the ring. She lost to Pula Sachin of Turkey due to losing weight. She was only 46 kg for a 48 kg bar. However, the silver medal made her more determined and hardworking, as the experience was golden. Next page, 36th page. In the course of my career, I have become used to travel and to the different ways that things work in other countries. One time in China, we were given chopsticks to eat our meals with. Just when I had painfully begun to master the art of using a knife and fork, I had to use two sticks to fill my stomach. I ended up using both my hands to hold the chopstick to pick up the food and push it into my mouth. My teammates asked the spoons, but I tried to manage with the sticks. It helped that I really enjoy Chinese food. I was hungry enough that I managed the complex work required. I ate enough to sat my appetite and my palate. After 5 years of traveling, I started taking along some packed food from home. Okay, from this paragraph, what you are going to learn is, while eating Chinese food, Mary Kom and her teammates were given chopsticks to eat their meals. They were not familiar with those chopsticks, so they struggled to eat their food with those sticks. Mary Kom, after a struggle to hold them correctly, used both her hands to hold the chopsticks to pick up the food and had it. Right. The next para, you listen. On my return, Delhi gave me a warm welcome at the airport. Back in Impol, I was greeted with garlands and drum beats and dancing. There was a victory ride across town. A felicitation program was held in Langol, an area that houses the government quarters. Thanksgiving prayers were said and words of praise and adulation were showered on me. I was presented with a traditional shawl. Oja Imbomcha was also present and was duly felicitated. When I spoke to the people in Langol the day, I spoke of my hope that I would win gold in future tournaments. Yes, dears, this paragraph tells about their achievements and how she treated by her family people and relatives. Okay. On her return to India, to New Delhi, at New Delhi, she was given a warm welcome. She was greeted with garlands, drum beats and dancing. There was a victory ride across the town and a felicitation program in Langol. There were Thanksgiving prayers, words of appreciation were showered on her, and a traditional shawl was also presented to her. Okay. Next paragraph. Listen carefully. The silver in Pennsylvania and the prize money from the government had put an end to my immediate financial worries. But I wanted a job too, for that alone can bring long-term security and a steady income. Also, around the time that I was getting married, I had no savings except my couple of life insurance policies. After my second world championship gold, the Manipur government offered me the post of sub-inspector, which I accepted in 2005. I had a long dreamt of getting a government job through the sports quota. And it was finally fulfilled. I earned a salary of rupees 15,000 in that first job. The thing about jobs that are obtained through the sports quota is that we are not required to go into work as regularly as our colleagues, because we tend to be away at camps and tournaments through much of the year. I go to office when necessary And every time I need to go out of station, I am required to take leave and inform the department. Right. The explanation of this passage is Marie Kong was born in a small village named Gangatri of Manipur. Her parents were very poor and were working in the fields of Jamma for earnings. From the very beginning, Marie Kong's aim was to remove poverty from her home. She even did street fighting for fulfilling the needs of her home. Her father was against boxing, but she knew her strength and passion. And passion and decided to continue her passion at any cost. When she was selected in the 48 kg category in Pennsylvania, she suffered financially. Listen, all I told already. So Marie Kong had long dreamt of getting government job in sports quota. So the Manipur government offered her the post of a sub-inspector in 2005. And she earned a salary of 15,000 in the first job. Lack of adequate financial resources affected Marie Kong to a large extent, but her grit and conviction took her to the sky. I think you can understand that. We'll come to the, and the next go to the last page. Page number 37. Yeah. Page number 37 in the next video. Okay, the last page, 37th page. Title in the 3rd World Women's Boxing Championships at Podolsk in Russia in 2005. Sarita, who had won the bronze, and I were given a hero's welcome at Impal Airport. We were taken to the Bhakyachandra Open Air Theatre, where a grand reception was organized. I had had a good run from 2001 to 2004. I won several golds, all the senior women's boxing championships, the second women's boxing championships 2002, the second Asian women's boxing championships at Hisar in 2013, and the Witch Cup boxing championships at Piast, Hungary. In spite of this, when I got married, everybody was doubtful that my medal halls would continue. Halls, I told the meaning halls at the beginning. Could you remember? Yes, hall means taking a collection. But after the wedding, I participated in and won a gold in the 3rd and the 4th World Women's Boxing Championships in October 2005 and November 2006. There were a number of other international level championships in Taiwan, Vietnam, Denmark, and so on. But it was retaining my world title in 2006 by defeating Steluta Duta of Romania 22-7 at the 4th World Championships in New Delhi, that I consider one of my greatest achievements. It is probably the most memorable for me because I was able to win at home. The other Indian boxers also performed exceptionally well. India won 4 golds, 1 silver and 3 bronzes. And our team won the overall title with this hat-trick of World Championship wins. The media christened me Queen of Boxing and Magnificent Mary. Okay, now I'll give the explanation of this passage. Listen carefully. Marie Kong was an Indian women boxer with an Olympic medal. She was a 5-time championship of world amateur boxing. She owns the record of being the single and the only woman to earn a medal in 6 world championships. She won a bronze medal in London Olympics in 2012. In the flyweight category of world rankings, IBA, she stood at the 4th position. She is Padma Bhushan awardee and has won uncountable awards till date. There were a number of other international level championships in Taiwan, Vietnam, Denmark and so on. But it was retaining her world title in 2006 by defeating Steluta Duta of Romania 22-7 at the 4th World Championships in New Delhi. That she considered as one of the greatest achievements, and she was able to win at home with a hat-trick of World Championship wins. The media christened her Queen of Boxing and Magnificent Mary. That's all, dears, from the lesson. Now, we go to the homework part. Just I gave at the beginning a glossary, meanings. These meanings you study at home and write in the notebook in front of your parents. Then, here we have 9 questions, 9 remark questions. So, this you can write the answers in the notebook and get signed from your parents and send it to me. Write neatly in your notebook. Kindly maintain, I already told you to maintain notebook. So, maintain notebook well. And then write neatly, legibly. Handwriting is very important. Good handwriting is needed. So, write neatly and send it to me. Okay? Thank you. God bless you.